in the gantry? Are they all up in the gantry?
There's a row of TV up in the gantry, the photographers in the foreground, the print press are sitting behind them.
Are they going to play the Bond music again?
Well, they've been playing that. I don't know what your introduction is, but they've been playing that all morning to keep
them alive. Excuse me.
You remember just to pause briefly. Just, when you get on the stage, you'll let the flashlights and then go popping. We put a little white mark just there, and then onto the, then after that, whatever you want to do.
Okay.
And then wander to the back there, and then
just sit down here.
The thing is, don't be surprised when you look to your right.
Why?
I'm not frightened. It's a mass all around the world. The photographers. There are so many of you having. When you do your stills, though, there could be three groups. So you do the same thing three times. Otherwise, it'll be like it was at your launch.
Oh, good.
And so this is more controlled.
I'm going to do a strip, you know that.
Great. Please. Not that relaxed.
I've got my tangerine jock strap on everything.
Isabella Spurupo, Sean Bean, Alan Cumming, Desmond Llewellyn.
Thank you very much. So, thanks, Pat. Nice to meet you. Thanks. Hopefully, yeah, I'll do everything I can, you know what I mean? Thank you very much. Thank you, Rob. Thank you very much.
Yes, I'm on my mark here. If I step over this, I don't look too good. What does it mean? It's pretty emotional in many ways, actually. Only because it was in my life in 86, and it went out of my life in 86. And, I don't know, when something happens in your life for a second time, it carries a certain significance.
I always played a Bond girl when I was a little girl.
I always wanted to be in a Bond film. All British actors want to be in a Bond film. It's pretty well genetic, really.
I was doing a movie in Los Angeles for the same studio, MGM UA.
You know, as an actor, you think, well, where's it going to take the career?
And they flew me out to London for the screen test, and then I ended up getting the part.
It was always a matter of time with my legs. You can quote me on that.
He's still a ladies man, yes. He has an eye for the women, certainly. It's a classic, Bunny. He gets the women, yes.
On the safe sex? No, I still dress up for that occasion, yes.
You should read the whole script, Alan. It's great. At the end, so exciting.
We have the Russian mafia in Australia.
What sort of man comes out in his pyjamas, honestly? Goodness.
Got to get the bad guys. See you, bye.
Thank you very much.
It's the one question that everybody asks, and I don't know. I just hope that I'm gonna bring to the character whatever is mine.
Do you have any gadgets?
Not that I can talk about on television. Just the trust, but that's a personal thing.
Oh God, that's a tough question. I mean, you know, my late wife, Cassie, she worked in For Your Eyes Only with Roger, and Roger, magnificent, wonderful, beautiful man. Sean, for me, as a, you know, when I was a boy of 11 years old, was the first Bond that I ever saw. If I see Sean Connery now, what would I ask him about the character? I wouldn't ask him a damn thing. Why should I?
Being Mr. Bond yourself?
Play Mr. Bond? No, they've already had one. Could be a handsome Scotsman. It'd be unfair to have two, I think.
Getting all white today. Are you getting any?
This is my plan.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. Eh?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.